Hi everyone, welcome to this video lecture. Myself M. Krishna, working assistant professor in EEE department, St. Peter's Engineering College. In this video, I am going to explain Ohm's law. The Ohm's law is stated as: in an electric circuit, the current passing through most materials is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across them. Means, the current passing, for example, there is a resistive material, we are applying some voltage for the resistive material, hence the current is passing through the resistive material. The passed current, which is passing through resistance, is directly proportional to the applied voltage with constant temperatures. We can see that there is one diagram for the Ohm's law. We are applying voltage across the resistance, current is flowing like this. So there are three forms of Ohm's law. So using this diagram, you can able to calculate the unknown parameters among three parameters which we are seeing in the diagram. Basically, this V indicates the voltage applied in volt. This I indicates the current flowing through the resistive material in ampere, and this resistance is the resistance of the material in ohm. So generally the Ohm's law is called as I directly proportional to applied voltage V. When we replace that proportional constant, we'll get I is equal to V is directly proportional to I. So this V is equal to Ri. So from that we can write the equation, this one. So if you want to calculate I, then go for the V by R. If you want to calculate applied voltage V, then IR. If you want to calculate the R, then go for V by R, V upon I. So for example, there are different voltage sources are available which we are seeing in the diagram. So 2 volt supply is there, 4 volt supply is there, 6 volt supply, 8 volt, 10 volt, 12 volt, like this we have different sources, and there is one bulb we are connecting. In between we are keeping one ammeter to know the how much current is flowing through the circuit. So when you connect a 12 volt source to the circuit, what is the glow of bulb, how it is going to be, how much it is going to be bright, like that. Mainly the concept shows that whenever the more supply is more, the resistance is constant there, thereby more current is flowing through the circuit, hence the bulb is also glows very brightly. Here we can see increasing the applied voltage V produces more current I to light the bulb with more intensity. So when we take some practical units applying Ohm's law here, for suppose 20 volt battery is there, DC supply is there. I know there is a 4 ohm resistance. I'd like to calculate current flowing through the circuit. For that we have one equation, I equal to V by R. So V is given, R is given, 20 by 4, we can get 5 ampere. So the 5 ampere current is flowing through the circuit. Same way, the current is given 1 ampere. When you see the second circuit, current is given 1 ampere, resistance is 12 ohm. So we want to find out the voltage applied. Then we have the equation V equal to IR. So just you substitute I value and R value, will get the voltage value as 12 volt. And when you see the third diagram, there the voltage is given, current is given, but we have to find out the resistance. To find out the resistance, we have the equation R is equal to the V by I. 6 volt is the voltage, 3 ampere is the current, thereby the resistance will be 2 ohm. So like that we can able to find the practical values also. It's very clear from the diagram. So when we want to find out the voltage applied, then go for the I is producting with the R. I is multiplied by R. If you want to find out the current flowing through the circuit, then you can see this is V upon R. V upon R. Suppose you want to find out this R, then you can see this diagram very clearly. R is equal to the V upon I. Like that we can able to remember this Ohm's law for the calculating the practical units. So as I said, the resistance is a linear element. It allows the output parameters based on the variation in the input values. So there is one table here, then one diagram is here. I have the voltage from 0 to 12 volt and resistance is 2 ohm. This I kept one ammeter here to know the how much current is flowing through the circuit. There is one table given here. So this table indicating what? For 0 voltage and we have the 2 ohm resistance, there is no current flowing through the circuit. So when we draw the characteristics for resistance, we are calling them as VI characteristics. Then we are taking current in ampere on y axis, current in ampere in on y axis, voltage in volts in on x axis. So for 0 voltage there is no current, just we keep on point here. For 2 voltage of applying voltage, then there is a 2 ampere current. Like that when you apply 10 voltage of volt, then that will become 10 ampere we are getting, not 10. See this, this is 2 ohm fixed one. Based on the equation I equal to V by R, we can able to calculate the points to draw the characteristics. Look at this. So this is 4 volt applied, 4 by 2 will get 2 ampere. 6 volt applied, 6 by 2 will get 3 ampere. 8 by 2 will be 4. Like that the current values are coming like that. We are keeping the points according to the calculation, then draw a line that passes from 0 to, it's a straight line passing through the 0. You can able to see the diagram on the screen. So when V is constant, I decreases as R is increase. I increases as R decrease. For example, if R doubles, I is reduced by half. If R is reduced to 1/4, I increases by 4 times. This is known as an inverse relationship. Linear resistance. There are two types of resistances. One is linear resistance, other one is non-linear resistances. A linear resistance has a constant value of ohm. Its R does not change with the applied voltage, so V and I are directly proportional. The examples for linear resistances are carbon film and metal film resistors. So this is one practical example which we can see on the screen. There is a voltage available from 0 to 9 volt and the resistance is a constant one, 2 ohm. Suppose it is a 2 ohm, then we are getting characteristics like this. If it is 1 ohm, we are getting characteristics like this. If it is 4 ohm, characteristics are like this. For smaller the resistor, the steeper the slope. When we see the non-linear resistances, in a non-linear resistance, increasing the applied voltage produces the more current. But I does not follow the increment in the voltage applied in a proportional manner. For example, volt ampere, when we see the volt ampere relationship, in non-linear resistance, let us take one tungsten filament in a light bulb. What happened is, when you apply the voltage to that bulb, the current is flowing through the bulb. After some times, the temperature of the bulb is going to be increased because it gets hot. Thereby, its resistance also increasing, means resistance not being the constant. Due to that, the volt ampere current doesn't follow the linear characteristics. It is following like this, means up to some time it is maintaining the linear characteristics. Afterwards, because of the temperature across the bulb is going to be increasing, which leads to makes the characteristics non-linear. We'll see one more, another non-linear resistance is a thermistor. Thermistor is a transducer device. It maintains the negative temperature coefficient, means whenever the temperature increases, the resistance of the material decreases, vice versa. Like that, initially it is exactly opposite to the previous topic, previous when we using the tungsten filament. So thermistor maintains the negative temperature coefficient, thereby initially it doesn't allow doesn't follow the input variations, and output current does not follow the input current, input voltage. That's why these characteristics also non-linear characteristics. For the non-linear characteristics, the Ohm's law not obeying. Electrical power. The practical units of power and work. The rate at which work is done is equal to the product of voltage and current. This is derived as follows. As we know, the volt, when we calculate volt, volt is in terms of joule per coulomb. So 1 volt voltage is equal to the 1 joule of energy to the 1 joule of charge, 1 coulomb of charge. Like that, 1 ampere is equal to the 1 coulomb of second. When we multiply this 1 volt and 1 ampere, we'll get the power. Power is equal to VI. So the power is calculating in terms of joule per second, and other unit is for power is watt, because the pioneer researcher Watt is invented the power calculations, thereby honor of his name, the unit of power will become watt. The amount of power dissipated in the resistance may be calculated using following equations. So this is P equal to I square R, P equal to V square upon R, P equal to VI. So these are the some power formulas. So we have to discuss about this. P equal to I square R. From that we can write R equal to P upon I square. And when we want to find out the I, then I equal to under root P upon R. So it is one of the practical example where we are applying 20 volt and 4 ohm is the resistance. There is a current flowing through the circuit is 5 ampere. Then find the power. Very simple, we have 3 different applications to calculate the power. First we'll see P is equal to the VI. Volt and current, when you product them, you will get power in watt. So in this case, 20 is the voltage, 5 is the ampere. When you multiply both the things, you will get 100 watt. The same value we have to get when you use the remaining equations. So open circuit concept and short circuit concept. Generally, these are comes in many electrical circuits to analyze them. So we can say when we have the open circuit, there exists infinity amount of resistance. So when you have the equation I is equal to the V by R, when we compare current and resistance, I is directly proportional to 1 by R. If the resistance is infinite value, the current value is 0. If the resistance is 0, the current is infinite, means indirectly saying that maximum. In case of open circuit, the resistance of the open circuit is infinity or maximum, which is inversely proportional to the current flowing through the circuit. Hence, the current in the circuit, when it is in open circuited condition, the current is 0. In case of short circuit, in the short circuit, resistance is 0. As you know, the relation between current and resistance, if the resistance is 0, the automatically current is maximum. So these two are the different concepts which we are seeing in analyzing the different electrical circuits. And any queries, you can ask in the next videos. Thank you for watching this video.